Greetings and salutations. Welcome to the calendar review of the 2012 calendar that has been first time produced in 2011 from the Fractal Forums crew. And the Fractal Forums crew consists of highly creative artwork creator that use techniques that didn't even exist a year before. And the calendar has been sold for €30, one exemplar, to support the fractalforums.com case. And it is open question if we manage to create another one this year. But let me show you the calendar from last year. And the title image is created by user Kraftwerk, namely Johan from Sweden, who is as well holding an exhibition in Karlstad, as Christian reported in his show. And it shows the programmer, the artist, and the mathematician. And those three guys are basically it in the forums. We have the mathematicians that create formulas, we have the programmers that realize those formulas, and we have the artists that play around with those formulas, creating nice images. And let me show you each page of the calendar now. And I start out with the January image. Which is made by Luis Marcoya, and he's a real well-known artist, not only in the fractal scene, he's relatively new to the fractal scene, but as rumors told me, he has as well worked with this famous Salvador Dali back in the 70s, and today he's using canvas oil paintings to create fractal art on canvas. And this is the year, listening for what could happen in the year 2012. And the second image is from Christoph Marczak, who is one of the programmers of the fractal program Mandelbulba. And this image shows a combination of incorporating a Euclidean object into a fractal scene, and it is as well using a nice water surface on the bottom of the image, and it's nice to have him inside the calendar, and it is a really good example of showing a water scene combined with a dawning sun. Very nice image. This is called Viaduct and is made by Christoph Marczak. The second image in the March is made from the other fractal programmer, namely Jesse, and this image is called Detail of the Quad Ray Set, and it is basically just one single formula that had been typed in by user Jesse, and it is as well showing a nice structure in the middle of the image, and it is great with the background. There are really nice structures in the fog and in the dust of the scene, and enjoy this picture, and it is really nice. And we have for the next month, we have an extraordinary nice picture, which is by Jeremy Brunet, a French fractal artist that is holding together with Kraftwerk in Karlstadt, Sweden, the fractal art exhibition. And it is showing the depth of field effect that can be incorporated in the images by normal rendering processes, and it's a really nice secret micro city, and you would like to live there perhaps sometimes, and perhaps there aren't or the little bees live in structures like this, because we have those balls coming out of the ground, and yeah, very nice image. And the next image is by Brent McNeely from the United States, and his username is Dane Bramage, but he didn't prove his brain damage to the forums yet. Perhaps it will show in the future. This time he's using a nice Eiffel Tower imagery that shows how 2D fractals look in 3D, and most people are reminded to an Sierpinski triangle, and you see those structures again. It has self-similarity, and the color sets are chosen nicely. If you like purple, this would be the perfect image for you. And okay, that's it for the May. Now we come to the next image, which is as well from user Bip, Jeremy Brunet from France, and it shows a nice underwater illuminated structure with light coming out of the center, and it has a really cool color setting, and it's really looking nice. And yeah, and this is one of the three images by user Jeremy. And that's it for the Jeremy image, the underwater amazing object. And let's come now to the next image for the July, which is by user Taurus, and he's using a nice underwater structure, a jellyfish standing around in the sea, and it is featuring as well a nice depth of field effect. And I like it very much because of its striking colors. It has red, green, and yellow streaks coming out of the object, and it is a really nice image that I adore very much, and this is really nice. Hold your knees for the next image, because the next image is one of the... Yeah. Just let me wait until we have the new image. And it is a Wasp Troll by user Kraftwerk, and this image rocked the house last year. It won the annual competition in the forums. It won the Benoit Mandelbrot Fractal Art Contest in 2011. And many people seem to like this, even if it makes some people scared, and you see so much detail on this picture. And the whole world seems to love Johann's Wasp Troll picture. And I personally find them a little bit scary, but if you come closer to it, you see new structures on every centimeter of the picture. The next image for the September is the third and the last image by user Jeremy Brunet. And Jeremy is a nice guy. He presented me this image as a printout last year on a even bigger size, and believe me, it is a nice image. And this is the first rendering of the burning ship formula, which is well known in the fractal scene from before. And this time he used a nice blue and yellow orange color setup that is really cool. And as I said before, it is the 3D variant of the burning ship formula. And let's continue with the calendar by the October image, that is the only 2D image in the calendar, and I wanted to include it because the author of this image is Ross Hilbert from the United States, and he is an expert for iterated function systems that usually are just 2D but have a 3D look on many variants on them. And this is the infinity's eye, with a blue eye centered in the middle of the image, and the streaks and nice spirals coming out of the image. And this is a representant for 2D variants of formulas and fractal images, but I wanted to have those 3D images at most in the calendar. So thanks to Ross Hilbert for contributing such great image to my calendar. And we have two images left, and we have the next image that is the point of origin by user Hal Tenney. And this image is an image that most people ask me, is this a fractal image or what is it? Is it a computer game or is it a rendering or a model in a 3D program? No, it is just a fractal formula rendered with a nice texture on it, and it shows some tubes and mechanical structure and a really dark setting of image. But that is the reason why it has been chosen for November, because November is it's a really dark and rainy month here in the Northern Hemisphere. And this is a really nice image because it looks so real or so human created, and you don't see that it is a fractal on the first sight. And we have the last image, which is the Fractal Beast by user Forrest Waltz from the States as well. And this is chosen by me because it has so a nice approaching feeling, where a dragon or a spaceship leaves the planetary atmosphere and starts out exploring new shores and new life forms everywhere in the universe. And it just says, this is not the end. The next calendar is hopefully be produced. And that's it for the calendar today. And I just have one more to say, which is a nice flower that I would like to present you, because I have to thank you for watching my show. And thank you for watching my show, please. And that's it for today. Next show will cover 2013 images of the calendar. And hope to see you next time. That's it.